Welcome 7th graders to the online session organized by your school KDPS. Today we will be studying your first chapter of social and political life subject, that is democracy. You might have heard this term, democracy, and that our nation is a democratic country. But have you ever thought about what that statement means? Huh? Have you ever thought about that? A democratic country is one where everyone is equal before the law. Every citizen has the right to challenge anything that is unjust. The Constitution of India is the guiding framework for the working of democracy in the country. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, the chairperson of the drafting committee, is considered to be the chief architect of our Constitution, who very carefully designed our constitution after studying the constitutions of about 60 countries. The preamble of the constitution itself clearly shows how carefully the words have been drafted to accommodate the interests of every individual in our nation. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic, and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic, and political liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith, and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact, and give to ourselves this Constitution. The Constitution declares India a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic, assuring its citizens justice, equality, and liberty, and endures to promote fraternity. What you see in this image is the original preamble framed in 1950. The words secular and socialist were added to the preamble in 1976 during the emergency declared by our then Prime Minister Indira Gandhi. But before we understand democracy in depth, let us try to understand two other forms of government, monarchy and dictatorship. You might have heard the term monarchy. An absolute monarchy means that the nation is ruled by a king or queen. Can you think of a nation that follows monarchy? I'm sure you might have guessed it right because you always hear about Queen Elizabeth. Yes, the United Kingdom is a monarchy of which Queen Elizabeth II is the head of the state. In a monarchy, the head of the state is chosen based on their birth into the royal family. The monarch and their immediate family undertake various official, ceremonial, diplomatic, and representational duties. Some of the other countries that follow a monarchy system of governance include Kingdom of Bhutan, Kingdom of Bahrain, Japan, Malaysia, and New Zealand. Can you try to find the names of a few more nations that follow a monarchy? Try finding the names. Another form of government is dictatorship, which is a type of government in which a single person or party has absolute power and the rights of the people are suppressed. The leaders of dictatorship are known as dictators, but they are not addressed as dictators in the modern world. They might be called president or prime minister. You might have heard of Hitler, who took over Germany as a dictator. Typically, dictators are put into power when a nation faces significant social issues such as high rates of unemployment or unrest among the nation's people. Both a monarch and a dictator have absolute powers and are above the law. They are not accountable to the people. But a democracy is very different from these two forms of government. Democracy stands for people's rule. People are involved in the formation of government, directly or indirectly through elections. There are two kinds of democracy, a direct democracy and a representative democracy. A direct democracy is one where the government is elected and run directly by the people. But this is impossible in countries with a large population. Switzerland is the only nation where a direct democracy is in practice today. Most countries, including our nation, India, follows a representative democracy or indirect democracy. Here, the people elect their representatives for a fixed term who form and run the government on behalf of the people. In our nation, we also elect the head of the nation, the president. Hence, India is called a democratic republic because we elect both the government as well as the head of the nation. Let's understand the meaning of the term democracy a bit more. The word democracy is defined from the Greek word demokratia, combining demos, which means common people, and kratia, which means power. Hence, democracy implies the rule of the people. Democracy has also changed over time. Democracy in ancient Greece did not grant voting rights to women and slaves. The modern understanding of democracy started taking shape in the late 18th century. New Zealand became the first nation to grant equal voting rights to all its citizens in 1893. Since then, many countries across the world adopted democracy and granted equal rights to all its citizens. Democracy keeps on evolving and accepts changes as our understanding of equality and human rights grow over time. But what makes democracy the most preferred choice of people across the world? Isn't that a question, children? That why is democracy preferred across the world? Abraham Lincoln described democracy as a government of the people, by the people, and for the people. Hence, the supreme power lies with the people of the country. A democratic government should always work for the welfare of all the people. Sabhi logo ke hit mein kaam karna hota hai. But a country's system of democracy will work well only if everyone freely participates in the governance, directly or indirectly. But how do citizens of a nation participate in its governance? Citizens governance mein kaise participate karte hai? Abhi hamara sawal hai. In a democratic system, people exercise their political power through elections. तो एक डेमोक्रेटिक सिस्टम में इलेक्शन बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट होते हैं. ऑल एडल्ट मेन एंड वुमेन वोट टू इलेक्ट देयर रिप्रेजेंटेटिव. हेंस वी कॉल आवरसेल्फ एज रिप्रेजेंटेटिव डेमोक्रेसी, वेयर रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स चोजन बाय द पीपल थ्रू देयर वोट्स एक्ट इन द अथॉरिटेटिव पोजीशंस टू मेक डिसीजंस फॉर द बेनिफिट ऑफ द पीपल ऑफ इंडिया. द कैंडिडेट और द पार्टी दैट गेट्स द मैक्सिमम वोट are elected to power. जिसको भी maximum vote मिलते हैं वो power में आता है और लोगों के हित में decisions लेते हैं, फैसले लेते हैं. If the people are not satisfied with their government, they can remove it in the next elections. The policies of the government also reflect the wishes of the people, that in public opinion. So that also reflects a public opinion. Hence, the three important features of democracy are, first, elections through which people cast their votes. Second, public opinion through which they express their opinion through their representatives. Third, rule of law, which considers everyone equal before the law. The president of the country and an ordinary citizen gets the same protection of the law. हर किसी के लिए लॉ बराबर है. देयर इज नो डिस्टिंक्शन बिटवीन द रिच एंड द पुअर और द एजुकेटेड एंड द अनएजुकेटेड. द रूल ऑफ लॉ ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड्स प्रोटेक्शन टू इंडिविजुअल्स अगेंस्ट सोशल इवल्स सच एज अनटचेबिलिटी, चाइल्ड मैरिज, सती एंड अदर फॉर्म्स ऑफ डिस्क्रिमिनेशन. कि हर तरीके के भेदभाव से भी हमें रूल ऑफ लॉ बचाता है। अब नेचुरली सवाल उठता है कि लॉज बनाता कौन है हमारे लिए, दैट हु मेक्स लॉज फॉर अस। व्हाइल इन अ मोनार्की और द डिक्टेटरशिप वेयर द किंग और द डिक्टेटर इज द लॉ गिवर, द किंग और डिक्टेटर लॉ गिवर होता है, लॉ देते हैं। In a democracy, the people make laws for themselves. In our country, the parliament constituted by the representatives of the people makes the laws for us. Similarly, the state assemblies make laws for the states. तो हमारे लिए जो हमारे चुने हुए representatives हैं, वो laws बनाते हैं। In spite of all the elements of democracy existent in the country, it may still not be truly democratic in its complete sense. Democracy is not just a form of government, but a form of society and a form of economy. The values of justice, freedom, and human dignity should be deeply embedded not only in the political system, but also in the social and economic life of the people. Hence, just a right to vote is not enough, but there should be a democratic society as well as economic democracy for a nation to call it a कम्प्लीट डेमोक्रेसी। तो सिर्फ राइट टू वोट होना ज़रूरी नहीं है या इनफ नहीं है हमारे लिए, सफिशेंट नहीं है हमारे लिए। इम्पॉर्टेंट है कि हम एक डेमोक्रेटिक सोसाइटी हों और साथ साथ एक इकोनॉमिक डेमोक्रेसी हो हमारे अंदर, कि इकोनॉमी में भी डेमोक्रेसी है। उसी की मदद से हम एक कम्प्लीट होलसम तरीके से डेमोक्रेटिक हो पाएंगे एज अ नेशन। अभी हमने बहुत सारी टर्म्स सुनी जो हमारे लिए नई हैं, टर्मिनोलॉजीज जो हमारे लिए बिल्कुल नहीं है। तो हम शुरू करते हैं डेमोक्रेटिक सोसाइटी से और इस टर्मिनोलॉजी को समझते हैं। When people have the right to elect and to remove their rulers, it is political democracy. तब हम उसे political democracy बोलते हैं। But the social life of people might still be filled with so much injustice. There could be discrimination or evils like caste system and untouchability, which spoils the democratic structure of a society. Here is the image of a village well from which some people are not allowed to draw water. Do you know what the reason is? आपको क्या लगता है कि क्या कारण होगा कि कुछ लोग पानी नहीं ले सकते हैं इस कुएं से, क्यों? It's because those people belong to a lower caste and hence cannot touch or use all public facilities. सारी public facilities वो specific caste के लोग नहीं ले सकते हैं। Even today, in some parts of India, Dalits face the same problem. Imagine कि community अभी भी India में similar problems face करती है। They are not allowed to touch functional hand pumps in upper caste villages. They need to travel kilometers and kilometers to another village to fetch water from a hand pump installed in a Dalit area. Sirf Dalit area se wo pani fetch kar sakte hai. Isn't it humiliating? Isn't it embarrassing? Children, try imagining yourself into a Dalit place. Try it. How would you feel about it? Would you like it if someone told you that you cannot drink water from a public shop or travel in the bus along with other passengers? Would you like it? So if you would not like to be treated like that, then it is also our responsibility to ensure that we do not treat anyone in such a way. कि हम किसी और को ट्रीट ना करें, ये हमारी जिम्मेवारी बनती है। वी मस्ट नॉट डिप्राइव एनीवन अराउंड अस ऑफ देयर बेसिक राइट्स। Everyone must be treated equally and no one must enjoy more privileges than others on the basis of religion, caste, race or place of birth. The caste system in India gave rise to untouchability in the past. Just imagine a situation where you are considered untouchable. लोग आपको अछूत मानते हैं कि वो आपको छू नहीं सकते हैं। छूएंगे तो या तो पाप लग जाएगा या वो अशुद्ध हो जाएंगे। Imagine this. Being not allowed to access all public places, आप हर जगह नहीं जा सकते हैं, and be required to travel at a distance from others. Will you feel nice about that? Will you? No, right. Hence, untouchability was abolished by our constitution, but it has already created a wall between the so-called high caste and low caste. It not only divided our society, but also deprived a large section of people of their basic rights. Our former president, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, has narrated an incident from his school days where he faced religious discrimination because he was a Muslim. When Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam was studying in his 5th standard, he was sitting next to his friend who was a Brahmin, a very dear friend to him. The teacher felt uncomfortable seeing that and asked young Kalam to sit in the last bench. Bola ki tum jaake aakhri bench pe baitho. He and his friend soon understood the reason and both were deeply hurt. Dono ko bahut dukh hua. His friend informed his father who had good repute in the village. Unke friend ne apne papa ko bata diya jinki bahut strong izzat thi village mein. His father at once called the teacher and asked him to not spread the poison of religious differences among children. Unke pitaji ne strong conviction ke sath bola ki aap ye zeher hamare gaon mein aur bachcho ke beech mein na phailaye. Luckily, the man's strong conviction and timely interference reformed the teacher. Teacher bilkul badal gaye the us discussion ke baad. Children, just imagine, if his friend's father has not taken such a stand, this discrimination would have followed throughout the year with them and it would have spread to others' children as well. We must be careful of such discrimination and never let it grow or spread among ourselves. A democratic society should be able to remove all these social differences. Thus, a truly democratic government is possible only with a democratically organized society. Children, have you seen a similar discriminatory practice happening around you? Koi bhi discrimination aapne apne aas paas hota ho dekha ho ya fir similar discrimination dekha ho? If yes, why do you think it happens? Sochiye ki kyun hota hai. Who are the ones who let such discriminatory practices spread to the society? Kaun use spread karte hain? What benefit do you think they get out of it? Agar koi kisi cheez ko spread kar raha hai to usko kuch benefit ho raha hoga. We need to think ki usko kya benefit ho raha hai. Think about it. What can you do to stop it at your level? Koi bhi discrimination usko stop karne ke liye aap kya kar sakte hain apne star pe? Sometimes, consistent small little steps are enough to unturn hard-rooted ideas and beliefs. Kai baar hamara har din lagan ke saath ek uthaya hua kadam bahut madad karta hai ek deep-rooted idea, assumption ya belief ko unturn karne ke liye, usko todne ke liye, usko ulta kar dene ke liye. Now, let's understand what do we mean by the term economic democracy. कि हम economic democracy से क्या समझते हैं? घर में काम ही क्या होता है? Children, have you heard this phrase? क्या आपने कभी सुना है किसी को ये बोलते हुए कि घर में काम ही क्या होता है? तुम सुबह से शाम तक करती क्या हो? या करते क्या हो? सुना है क्या आपने कभी? Those who have heard it know that this is said mostly to the women working at home from dawn to dusk, and still the work they do isn't counted neither by children nor other family members. All of it stirs some questions like, ye sari cheeze kuch sawal khade karti hain, jaise ki whose work is counted and why, kiska kaam gina jata hai aur kyun, who is allowed to work and why, kisko permission di gayi hai kaam karne ke liye aur kyun, what is the role of work done out of emotions in our economy than only for earning money. कि पैसा कमाने के लिए किया गया काम होता है एक और दूसरा कि मैं एक मोशन से काम कर रहा है कोई तो उन दोनों की क्या वर्थ है एक दूसरे के सामने we compare it. और what is the importance of work done selflessly कि आप बिना किसी expectation के बिना किसी return के कुछ काम कर रहे हैं and without getting any money out of it. And if we compare that work, the work done selflessly with the work done for earning money, क्या वर्थ है उस वर्क की? What is the importance? चलिए अब इन सब सवालों के बीच में अब हम ये समझते हैं कि इकोनॉमिकली डेमोक्रेटिक नेशन क्या होता है. An economically democratic nation is one in which all have equal economic opportunities. All should be free and self-reliant in earning their livelihood. This does not mean that all should earn the same amount of income. कि हर किसी को same amount का पैसा कमाना है और live in the same type of houses. कि same तरीके के घर बने हो, same amount of पैसा खर्च किया गया घर बनाने के लिए. Or that qualification must not be a criteria for getting employment. इसका मतलब ये नहीं है. What it means is that all should have equal opportunities टू बी एम्प्लॉयड और टू सेट अप देयर ओन बिजनेस. सबके पास बराबरी की अपॉर्चुनिटी होनी चाहिए, सेम प्लेइंग फील्ड होना चाहिए जब वो अपना काम शुरू कर रहे हैं. इकोनॉमिक डेमोक्रेसी ऑल्सो मीन्स एब्सेंस ऑफ एक्सप्लॉयटेशन. कि जहाँ शोषण ना हो वहाँ पे हम बोल सकते हैं कि वहाँ इकोनॉमिक डेमोक्रेसी है. द वर्कर्स शुड नॉट बी एक्सप्लॉयटेड. तो शोषण किस सेंस में? काम के क्षेत्र में. बाय द ओनर्स एंड द पेजेंट्स मस्ट नॉट बी एक्सप्लॉयटेड बाय द लैंडलॉर्ड्स. इक्वल वेजेस शुड बी गिवन फॉर इक्वल वर्क. देयर मस्ट बी अ फेयर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ वेल्थ इन द सोसाइटी. वेल्थ को फेयरली डिस्ट्रीब्यूट किया जाना चाहिए. इफ वेल्थ इज कंसेंट्रेटेड इन द हैंड्स ऑफ अ फ्यू देयर कैन बी नो इकोनॉमिक जस्टिस. Look around and make notes of instances that reflect either economic equality or inequality. अपने आसपास देखो, observe करो, find out करो कि कहाँ पे आपको लगता है कि economic terms में equality है और कहाँ पे economic terms में equality नहीं है. Democracy is based on two important principles, liberty and equality. Individual freedom and equal opportunities are necessary conditions for democracy to be successful. Hence, a democratic government will be meaningful only if its citizens are socially equal and economically free. It is the responsibility of each one of us to help the government remove any inequality or discrimination that exists in our society. I believe you all will take small little steps towards it. And will try to stop a discrimination that is happening around you. Your small little efforts can lead to great results in future, children.